Move.
Can't be like a horse with blinkers.
Honestly, say I was about to have
corrupt,
sex and then I pulled
crap,
up.
But it's nice.
We've attracted a lot of young talent, enormous talent. But our main aim is to get them out of the streets, those who go astray from the temptations of drugs, alcohol abuse, and then that leads to crime. However, our objective at the end of the day would be that they must be able to become professional musicians, you know, real good musicians, and they can carry it over to the next generation.
I know this environment, especially where I'm staying, man. This place was very rough, you know. And okay, I've never been in school before, understand? But music changed me. I know even those kids, they want to change, man. Never mind others, they smoking drugs, they do bad things, they're going to change, definitely. From 80s I was volunteering till now I'm volunteering, man. To me it's nice, man, it's great because I want to sit with kids and show them things, music, instrument. Understand? Yeah.
Aha! Hey. 1, 2, 3, 4.
We have a lot of talent in our community, and it's going astray. And I, as an ex-principal of a school, felt as a retired person, this is a worthy cause. So I'm here as a treasurer, secretary, I do anything. So we've been working and walking with Porky. Porky is a wonderful dream. And I felt, as a community worker, this is a wonderful idea.
When you are young, but the gangsterism and drug abuse and alcohol abuse was not like this, you know. Yeah, although the streets were rough, but not rough as today, you know. But today the kids are exposed to booze, they're exposed to drugs, you know. So a place like this can keep them away from those things. After school, they just come here. Because what's happening, there's no recreation. After school, these boys, they just put their books there and maybe finish their schoolwork and go to the streets. You know, that's where they get another theories, get theories, you know.
1, 2, 3, 4.
When I was young in the Eastern Cape, in Queenstown, there were no such schools. There were no schools, actually, at all for black people. But we had very good musicians who were our role models. We could hear them. And some of them actually hit the international scene.
And this drum is called his net drum. You want to come in between, and then you know, I had some big crash.
Pookie actually, he played bass with me. So when he used to play bass, I used to get on the drums and he used to show me how to do swing and how to. He actually first taught me jazz. That's why I know how to play jazz right now. So whenever he used to practice, I used to practice with him, and that's how I learned. And he's the one that actually taught me. That's why I'm here today, it's because of him.
The aim of the project is to get these kids to be where this current drummer is sitting right here at the back of me now. Kuhle is his name. He plays with the band. He started here, he worked his way out. This is the idea of the project. You start here, you do all the basics, you become advanced, then you go out to a higher level where he is now. He's actually playing with the band. When the band has got gigs, they call him. He's the drum player of the band. He's studying music at UCT. So this is the whole idea of passing on from one generation to another. I mean, we will all be gone, then he will be there again and stand up. And so, we also have the same thing in mind for these little kids here as they grow up. Because as you can see, witness yourself, there's a lot of passion. We will obviously encourage them to become like him, because now he's become a role model and we're extremely proud of him.
One, two, three.
There are musicians that comes out here and they do this thing voluntarily until such time when we can get a sponsor to really pay these people, because these people, they also have families to maintain. But at the moment it's going very well. We're very, very happy. We're happy to have networked with many, many people that has got influence. The community is 200% behind us. The street, the surrounding areas, they are 100-200% behind us, and that's a good thing.
Because there was nothing like this, but we were lucky enough because there was something at Langa. There was an old man who used to play a piano, and then he decided to open a little school at his workshop in Langa. So he had a piano there, so we used to go there. That's where we started to read music. He gave us a theory of music. And then instrument, because he was a pianist, you know, there was no somebody who teaches trumpet, so we could find our ways to get to the trumpet, you know, to the horns. All the horn players basically taught themselves, you know, how to play trumpet, but he was helping us with theory, you know, of music.
Well, I heard about the school from my dad and said I must come and join. And then I said, okay. I'll try, do my best to come to this school at any cost during the week if I have to.
He is so serious about his schoolwork, so I always urge him to practice trumpet.
My son mostly, I won't lie. When I look for him, he'll be in his room, he'll be playing, he'll be listening, he'll be playing either the games, or mostly he'll leave his friends to play games and he'll be playing guitar. And it's quite surprising to get a young man like this, you know, a boy loving jazz as he is. Because I grew up, I was born in Simonstown. There were old Jazzenians in those days in Simonstown at Luyolo location. I used to be about the age of 2 years at that time, while in Simonstown. They used to put me on the stage. I'm not surprised when I see him, you know, loving jazz the way he is. He listens to Wes Montgomery. He's got an ear for music. He's got an ear for jazz, which is very seldom. There's kwaito, there's a lot of other music, but he'll rather play this jazz. I don't know, it's just different.
I came here because I love music, and I come from a family that was inspired by music. So my mother sings, my sister sings, she's got an upcoming album. Her name is Tembi. Yeah, I came here to learn music because I want to achieve and be like people like Wes Montgomery and Joe Pass and Barney Kessel.
My dream is that we produce well respected, well respected musicians who can compete with anybody in the world, and that they interact with their peers in other parts of the world, and teach, continue preaching the gospel of music. Also, music as an answer to all these other dangerous addictions.